Belanova is the main character of Dog Run. She is a writer. She's kind of poor. She's struggling in the Lower East Side of New York City. She is balancing jobs. She begins in a not very good relationship with a guy. I feel in some ways like American culture now, it's highly competitive. It almost starts in grade school as far as getting into the good schools and the top places. And in a way, it curtails, it cuts the opportunities for a lot of people who blossom later in life. You know, I'm seeing this more and more in our society today. I know that the Lower East Side was a ghetto. It was a low-income neighborhood. We had a lot of bars and clubs and venues, and which led to a lot of parties. So it was conducive to kind of being not so responsible, getting drunk. But I guess I'm just saying that I feel like a lot of the characters in my book would be successful at another time or another place when those opportunities were still there, but they're not really anymore. New York City really is fast-paced. It's kind of crazy how there's almost a competition in many ways, and how it, one thing accelerates other things. New York is this very New York moment, or New York minute, as they say. Things go very, very quickly. I think there's also some sense that, you know, the faster you move, the more successful you are. I guess in Mary's case, you know, by the end of the book, her world in many ways is falling apart. So she's really trying to keep it together and avert disaster. The final message of Dog Run, I would probably say, is stay at home, live with your mother, don't go out, and die a quiet death. I didn't really have a message. Being published in France is unbelievable. The way that writers are treated here is vastly different than in America. In America, you're almost discouraged from writing. There's this kind of, even when they publish you, it's like, all right, you know, you're in. But there's very little respect. There's very little follow-up from the editors. They usually will publish maybe two books, and then you're out again. And it's a tremendous competition getting published. I feel like getting published in France, I almost wish, I wish I spoke French, and I wish I wrote the book in French, and I wish I just published directly and only in French, because, you know, I hate to say it, but I just think the treatment of American writers, it really is, you know, if you go to the right school and you pay a lot of money and you get to the right programs and the right people and the right mentors, you're in. But I don't know if literature should be as competitive as business, because a lot of great writers really were losers, if you want to call it that. And in a way, I feel like this process is eliminating a lot of potentially wonderful, terrific, innovative writers. Like, I don't think William Faulkner would be published today in America. I don't think a lot of really terrific writers would make it in America today, and that's a tremendous tragedy. You know, there's much more conventionality in the fiction, I believe. So to get to your original question, I love France. I wish instead of going to America, my grandparents stopped here, and I could have begun again in French.